Hey, welcome along. This is the Last Cast Adventures Fishing Tinny. It's a small boat and there's five of us. So you can imagine it gets pretty crowded pretty quick. And when we're all on the boat and we're all going fishing, that means multiple rods, lots of tackle, food, you name it, everything's going on. So we need to make sure everything is tidy. We're going to run you through some of the key accessories we've added to this boat to make it a really practical platform for me and the family to be out running around chasing fish and having adventures. So the track wedge system is attached simply by using a screwdriver. You don't need to drill into the boat. I'll show you now how it works. It's very easy, just screw it straight in. Not every small tinny is going to have this gunnel track, but a lot of them do these days. So the track wedge system is the way to go. It's that simple to fit the track wedge. If you don't have a gunnel, then you can buy the side ports and the star ports and you can permanently mount them. I can move the track wedges around really easily to suit whatever accessories I'm running, whether I'm putting the bimini on, whether I'm moving the bait board from this side to that side of the boat, whether we're running the fish finder or not, rod holders, cameras, especially for cameras. We're running cameras all around the boat at times. And it's good to be able to just reposition them, and I can move to get the right angle. I can just move the star port mount further forward or further back and I can get the best angles. So when you're heading out fishing on a boat like this, one of the most critical things is your rod storage. Keeping the rods out of the way and where you need them. What we've got on this boat, we've got obviously the star ports and the side ports to allow you to mount any of the rod holders in the range. We've got the rod holder 2, the rod tube, the rod holder R. We even got the rod holder extender, which allows you to extend your rod holder over the boat or get it on the right angle that you need. Another two really functional options for your rod holders is the rod stow and the rod rack. Now these look after your rods while you're actively fishing or moving around to and from fishing spots. If you want to get up the front, cast and chase into fish like these ones, you don't want rods sticking up in your way. You don't want rods lying around on the deck because you're going to get tangled and you're probably going to snap rods. So having the rod stows and the rod racks means you can lay the rods down or move them out of the way so that casting area is free. And the great thing about the rod stow is it's also got these little storage caddies. So I can put bone, pliers, lures, all sorts in there. And it means you can carry multiple rods and keep it practical. We can run 5 to 6 rods on this small boat. We're even using the pole holder, which will hold onto our gaff and our net. Having a fillet table or a workbench somewhere that you can move to different positions on the boat is really useful to have. The Railblazer fillet table comes with adjustable mounts on the bottom here. So we can simply take it out, reposition it anywhere on the boat. You have the option to get extenders. You can lift the bait board higher, or you can extend it on the adjustable extenders and move it outside of the boat. It's a really practical workstation. This whole system is completely removable, so your fish finder doesn't stay on your boat. If you're up the front of the boat and you need to watch the sounder, you can just swing it around like so. You need somewhere to secure your phone on the boat, the Mobi device holder is what you need. Comes in the adjustable and the fixed option. Now the easiest way to run lights on a small tinny like this is self-powered navionic lights. This is by far the easiest way to have your nav light system set up on a small boat like this without having to power in. These lights are fully waterproof and they float. When you don't need them, you can keep them stowed away safely in your locker. This is only a 3.85 meter boat. Granted, it's got high sides, so you've got a lot of cockpit space, but they can lose that space pretty quickly when you're running 3 or 4 people on here and you're all trying to fish. So having this system where we can stow our rods on the sides, we can put our rods into the rod stow, keep our whole cockpit clear, means it's a lot more enjoyable for everybody. So if you've got a little fishing tinny and you want to make it practical, check out Railblazer. It's a fantastic product. We love it.